Yeah, it's polite, but it's not law, is it? It's polite, but it's not law.
It's polite, but it's not law. So you're just being polite, but okay, no worries.
Yeah, pretty much. So the same as you, really. Mate, there's cameras everywhere. There's cameras everywhere.
Yes, but I don't know what you're going to use that for. I know what they use those for.
What do we use it for?
Surveillance.
All right, maybe I'm surveying.
Maybe you are.
Yeah.
You're really good at it if you are surveillance, aren't you?
Well, yeah. Early days on the job.
Oh, great.
Yeah. You'll be on YouTube anyway. Well, just keep to yourself and I'll be gone. I'm telling you now.
No problem.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It ain't going anywhere, up into my photo albums as an archive, alright? Yeah. It'd take too long to tell everybody what I'm doing though, wouldn't it?
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah. Hey, didn't get my permission. What an ugly landscape. Didn't take long. Can't even escape it in the town centres. Another safe and effective, maybe. Well, everyone's nice and sedated. Obviously, at the market, you've got the procedure kicking on still. And it'll be a matter of time before some liberal wants to tear that down. Waiting for an English face to get in there. And this must be the market area in Birmingham. World famous rag market.
Hello.
Guess the continent. Face nappy. All foreigners. You all right?
Quick question.
Go on then.
Oh, thank you very much. My name's Donnell. What's your name, sir?
Bill.
Bill, nice to meet you, Bill. So, Bill, I work with a company called Inside Success. All trying to do is like mentor for knife camera young people. I put them onto our courses and workshops. We aim to teach them things like trading, making music, property, marketing, literally whatever they want to do, we give them the skills and the qualifications to get a career of their choice and turn their life around.
Mm-hmm.
Now, alongside this, we help out their mental health by giving them therapy sessions, counseling, anger management, and mentoring all for free. The best thing about it, that it's not a sign up, it's not a subscription. I don't want any of the details.
Yeah.
All it is just a one off, whatever you feel comfortable to give, just this one time, by cash or card, so I'll fund this course in the workshops and help me reach my target.
Without being rude, I'm not giving any money, but I was just interested in what you're doing, that's all.
Thank you, anyways.
Yeah.
Well, appreciate it.
Well, I hope it goes well for you anyway.
Thank you very much. All right. Have a nice day.
And West. Fucking chaos. So busy. Good though, obviously. And over here, just got the oblivious normies. So I just want to comment on the contrast here. So down there you've obviously got the Free Palestine demo. And then over here obviously got the Christmas market. Nice, it's full of life in here. You alright all? So today we're from Birmingham yesterday. The videos, obviously these are some of the images. To add a bit of context to the intro where I was arguing with that guy at the market, so basically I stood a good distance away. I think his missus had clocked me earlier on because I had a camera, and but I'd clocked them as well, and I thought that's a very English, British looking market stall, so I'd like to photograph it, but I don't like to be noticed. I tried to keep my distance, stay but you know, unobserved. And anyway, I come back round, I've done my walk around the indoor market, seeing everything that was going on around in the outdoors, and then I came back to photograph them, and I kept my distance, and I was zoomed in, and he kept looking at me, he clocked me, kept looking at me, and then he goes, isn't it polite to ask someone before you take the photo? And obviously my response was, well, you know, maybe I'm not polite. And he's like, and then obviously you see where it goes from there. But the point I want to get to, if he happens to watch this,
you know, as you should know, photography is not a crime, and you can go on about politeness, but photographers in particular, being a street photographer, you have to just capture the moment. There's a really good example a couple of weeks ago when I went to Bury St. Edmunds. I was walking past a church and a choir was singing, and I went in there and I just cracked on and started taking the photos, and I captured it, because that's what it's all about, just capturing that moment. Now, if I'd have messed about asking for, you know, whether I could take your photo, it doesn't work that way. I don't have to do that anyway, because the law is I can photograph anything I want as long as it's not indecent, because that's how all these CCTV cameras get away with it. And worryingly, these big corporations and the police and all the rest of it, the government, you can't really trust, in my opinion, have got copyright to your face, as does members of the public if they photograph you. So you're not very concerned about them, but we're living in something of a surveillance state now. You could easily be incriminated for things you didn't do with deepfake technology, and so on. So if you're going to be concerned about me, I would hope you'd be concerned about people filming you from all angles that you don't know. I'm sure if you put a person behind the cameras all around the city, you'd be asking why they're filming you. But because there's no person behind it visibly, but someone in a control room somewhere that's filming you, that's why you get upset. Now, as you saw, so basically after the little confrontation argument, I walked away and I thought, you know what, adrenaline was starting to go down a bit. I thought, I'll go back in, make peace. There's no need to end it on a bad note. So I went back in and said, look, mate, you know, nothing to worry about. And he raged over and shut me down because maybe he was thinking that he'd overreacted. I get it. He probably doesn't like strangers taking his photograph. And I just wanted to reassure him it wasn't going anywhere dodgy. So we shook hands, but what he said to me at the end, I thought was quite daft. He goes, you know, you just need to tell people what you're doing. I was like, can you see the insanity of that and the time that I'd take, the logistics? I'd have to run around all of Birmingham telling people what I'm doing. And then what do I do if people leave and new people come in? Do I have to keep running round and round and just keep going around in circles? It's daft. And I don't have to anyway. That's the law. You know, people are allowed to take videos, photos. I walked past no end of cameras yesterday, people filming things and taking photos. I'll be in the background of someone's photo today, no doubt. I don't care. You know, so what? A photo is just an artificial variation of like a human brain and eye. It does exactly the same thing as what your memory and your brain does. And the black guy who's doing the stop knife crime thingy, you know, trying to get money for people, you know, getting them into educational systems instead of going around bloody, you know, doing what they do to each other. I'm not being funny. I bumped into them people in Wimbledon in London. I've never given them money. I just think it's daft. You know, these people are going to do it regardless of whether I give you money. A lot of these African lads that have come here, I'm sorry, but it's in the nature, it seems, to just go around stabbing each other and causing crime. You know, the statistics say it all, and the news headlines every day kind of tells me all I need to know. Funny enough, later on, I'm sure, 50% sure it was him walking down the high street, sort of rapping to himself or something. So the nice, articulate manner he had earlier had transformed into, you know, his real self a bit later on. So other than that, that's Birmingham daytime. Later on, I'll get around to uploading the video footage from the night time, which was quite... There was definitely a change in the atmosphere to the night time for the better. I found people much more livelier. The alcohol was kicking in. People coming out on the piss. It was so busy. Even London, you know, is on a par with how busy that was. At night time as well, I remember walking out from the cathedral bit where the market was and walking down one of the high streets. One of the side streets, sorry, down to the high street. And it was just rammed the whole way down. So, and also, just before I forget, the guy at the beginning, at the market, there was only about two or three English people left on the stalls. So that's why I wanted to photograph them. You know, because if they go, then it's more or less a fully foreign market, really. And that's it. Cheers.